Good morning. Myself Prahala Savant Badkar, Assistant Professor, DKT Textile and Engineering Institute, Inchal Karanji. Okay. Today I'll go for the fourth video on the CAM 4. Okay, in previous three videos I have explained regarding the types of the CAM and types of the follower and nomenclature of the CAM also. Today I'll go for the important thing, that is the motion of the follower. Today I'll go for the motion of the follower. Before that one, I will explain the things. These are the some nomenclature you need. What are the nomenclature you need? It means that is the angle of ascent, that is a pi, then angle of the downward and angle of the descent, I will take it as a pi d, and angle of action, this is a total angle for the single one rotation of the cam, that is a total angle of the action. Okay, in some textbook they will use as a theta e also, ascend also, dull also, descend, in different word also. Angle of ascent means some textbook they will take it as a angle of rise, angle of dull period, angle of return. Okay, they will pronounce in that way also, they will write it as a, in that way also. In that case, they may be taken as a theta. So here I have taken as a pi, instead of they will take it as a theta also. Theta A, and some textbook they will take it as a RA. Okay, rise, return. They will take it as a, in this way also. Okay, then I will go for this. What is the things it will explain? Okay, this is a cam. If you consider this is a cam, this is I have taken as a one of the knife edge follower. Cam rotation is, I will take it as a omega, that is a omega angular velocity. Okay, for one rotation, this is a lift of the follower, h. H is nothing but a lift of the follower. Okay, I will explain this one. What is the angle of ascent, angle of descent? This is a dull period, delta 1. I have taken as a delta 1, dull period. What is the meaning of the dull period means? Cam rotates, but follower is a stationary at upper position or lower position. Then this is a dull period, first one. This is a pi, rise of the follower. Then one will find it is a dull period, then return of the follower, then dull period. This is a one cycle. One cycle means it is a one rotation of the cam. Okay, the vertical is indicates the follower displacement, horizontal distance, horizontally you can rate it as a cam angle. Vertical is follower displacement, horizontal is cam angle. Then I will come to the motion of the follower. Motion of the follower, you will find a four types, that is simple harmonic motion. Second, constant acceleration, deceleration, constant velocity, then cycloidal motion. These are the four types of the motion of the follower. What I am clearly I am saying, this is the motion of the follower. Okay. Then, I will explain one by one. Then first I will go to the simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion. In that case, S is a follower displacement. That is a instantaneous. Instantaneous. Then H is a maximum follower displacement. V is the velocity of the follower. Theta is a cam rotation angle. Cam rotation angle for the maximum displacement. Beta is the angle on the harmonic circle. One more name is, that is a harmonic circle, that will call it as a semicircle also. Okay. Then I will explain one by one. This is, I will remove this one. It is, I need to explain this one. I will remove this one. Then, instantaneous means you have to say that is at instant time only. Here also written as instantaneous means that is instant at particular time only. Okay. Then construction of the SH. This is a construction of the simple harmonic motion. How to construct of the follower? Okay. These are the some steps you have to remember it. That is a semicircle diameter equal to cam rise or fall. That is a total lift of the follower. That is designated as a H. Then divide the semicircle into n equal parts, n equal arcs or parts. Second, you have to make it as divide the cam displacement equal to n divisions. Okay. Then third is a project the intercept. Fourth is a join the points with the smooth curve. I have completed this one. I have drawn this one. Okay. This is will get it as a simple harmonic motion. I will explain one by one. First, you have to do that. You have to draw the vertical horizontal. This is a horizontal is a cam angle. You take it as a cam angle. Then vertically, it is a nothing but a height of the lift of the follower. You have to take it as lift of the follower. That is the edge. Then you have to draw the semicircle. Okay, I will draw the semicircle. What is the radius of the semicircle means? Radius of the semicircle is half of the h by 2. That is a total lift divided by 2. That is the gives the radius. Otherwise, it is a total diameter is h. Radius is h by 2. Then, what the things you have to do it? In this case, this is a semicircle. This is about 180 degree. In that case, you have to make a equal number of divisions. Okay. If you take as a n number as n as a 6, then 180 divided by 6 means it comes as a 30 degree. Then you have to divide it 30 degree. This is a 30, this is a 30, this is a 30, this is a total it comes as a 6, I think so. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But one thing you have to remember it, you have to make it as an even number only. You can go for the 8 also. 180 divided by 8. Whatever the angle is there, you have to divide that one. Then, how many divisions you have made n semicircle, you have to make it as a same division on the cam angle also. That is a horizontal also. You have made as a 6. Here also you have to make it as a 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have to make it 6. Then, here also I made as a same. Here also I have taken as a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Then here also on the semicircle also I made as a 6 division. Okay. On the semicircle. Semicircle and harmonic circle both are the same. Don't take it as a different. Then you have to project the line from the 0 to 1 to 1. You have to intercept the line horizontally. 1. 2. You intercept. 3. 4. 5. You intercept it. Then where it makes an intersection 0, 0, 0, horizontal, 0, 1, 0. 1, here also 1, you have to mark it, 1. Intercept of the 2, intercept of the horizontal semicircle 2, you have to mark it. 3 also you have to mark it, 3. 4 is also you have to mark it on 4. 5 is also on mark it on 5. 6 is you have to mark it on 6. Then you have to smoothly join these points. This is a nothing but a SHM, simple harmonic motion. Whatever the things I have explained here, I have drawn here only. 6 divisions, 6 division on a semicircle, the diameter of the semicircle is equal to h, radius equal to h by 2, okay. I have taken from the, this is a theta is 0, this is a cam angle, when it comes as a theta is maximum angle is pi angle. Okay, beta is, that is a angle of semicircle or harmonic circle. Okay, at any instant. Then I will explain the derivation. Then you have to come for this one. I have taken this figure separately here. Separately, whatever the, in order to avoid the confusion, I have written here only. Okay, you look at this one. This is, look at the figure. I have taken as a, this is half portion only. Half portion only. Can you get it? I have taken as a half portion only. Okay, that is h by 2. Then, this is a subtended angle beta. Can you find it? Then, what is a, I need a displacement of the follower at the instant of point 2. This is a point, I need it. I need a displacement at the this position. At any instant means any time, at particular instant only. What is the height of this one? This is displacement. S is the, what is the follower displacement at instants. That is a, any instant, S equal to total. This I need a, what is the position of this point? Clear what I am saying? I need a position of this point. What is that point? This h by 2 minus this length. I need this point. Clear what I am saying? I need this point. What is this? H by 2 minus h by 2. You will get it as a, you take it as a common, then you will get it as a 1 minus, you take it as h by 2 as a common. Then further, what I am saying here, rise or fall of the follower displacement h. For that displacement, initially, you look at the figure. When theta is 0, theta equal to maximum is, it is a pi. Okay, when theta equal to pi, when it is at this condition, beta is what? The instantaneous angle, semicircle angle, that is a beta equal to pi. This is a beta is a minimum, maximum is a, this is a pi. Pi is a 180 only. Okay, when it is a theta equal to pi, beta is maximum. Then I will keep in the form of all the angles, I will keep in the form of beta equal to, by ratio method only, by ratio concept, beta equal to pi theta by pi. Then you substitute this value, whatever the beta value is there, here beta value is there, substitute in this equation, yes equation, that is a beta, you replace it, then you replace it. Then omega is the angular velocity of the cam. Everybody knows this one. This is a cam rotates. Omega. This is a follower. Okay. Omega is the angular velocity. Then angular distance equal to omega into t. Okay. By formula. Then you substitute this one. You replace theta equal to omega t. Then you will get it as a s. Then directly I went for the velocity. Velocity equal to, with respect to time only, ds by dt. I went directly, you will get as a equation as a h by 2 pi omega pi sine pi theta by pi angle. Then, what is a Vmax? This is an important bit. Vmax is, when it becomes a maximum, when theta becomes a pi by 2. Look at the figure. When it is a maximum, this is a theta becomes a pi by 2. You substitute that value. If substitute that value, you will get it as a h by 2 pi omega pi, when it is a theta equal to pi by 2. You have to remember this also. This is a concept is useful. Then you have to come to the acceleration. In acceleration also, derivative of the velocity, that is a dv by dt. Once again, I written as a directly this one. With respect to t only, then h by 2 pi omega pi angle whole square. This is a whole square, cos pi by theta, pi into theta divided by pi. Then acceleration is a, when it is a maximum, you put the cos 0 becomes, if you put it as a cos theta equal to 0, then this becomes a 1, the f max becomes a maximum. H by 2 pi omega divided by pi angle whole square, when theta equal to 0. Then I'll come to this one. When it is a maximum, velocity is a maximum. When it is acceleration is a maximum, we can find it using this displacement curve, velocity and acceleration. Okay, this is a displacement, this is a horizontal is cam angle. For the three cases, horizontal is a cam angle only. You have to remember it. Horizontal is a cam angle only. Now, displacement, when it is a, this is a SSM curve, whatever the things he got it, this is, he got it SSM curve only. This is exactly this one. Then what I said, velocity is a maximum. When it is a velocity is a maximum, look at this one. I have written as a velocity is a maximum when theta equal to pi by 2. What is a pi by 2? This is a maximum angle pi. Divided by points, that is comes as a 90. When sine 90 is, automatically velocity is V maximum is this one. Can you find it? Then acceleration is, when it is a minimum, when it is a maximum, look at that one. When theta is 0, when theta is 0, look at this figure, this is formula. When theta is 0, here, the acceleration is a maximum. What is the value? That is a F max here. Here also F max. This is a negative side also, deceleration F max is, this is also maximum. But when it is a minimum, when you put it as a 90 degree, cos 90 degree, that becomes a 1. This is 90 degree, this is a minimum case. It is a 0 is, that is a maximum case. When cos 90, it becomes a whole things becomes a 0. Then this is a minimum for the acceleration. I stop here only, that is whatever the things I have explained related to SHM, these figures you have to remember it, because in order to solve the numerical problems on the SHM, you need it, you remember it. Thank you.